Hello students, today's lesson is International Initiatives for Elder Care. In the 20th century, the problem of the social exclusion of senior citizens has been recognized by international organizations, both the public and government organizations. Since the 80s, action have been taken to tackle stereotypes and improper attitude towards the elderly. Especially, United Nations organization addresses its efforts through various policies, dialogue, capacity building, data collection, research and advocacy for empowerment of the elderly. UNO facilitates the development of evidence-based policies and supports culture and gender-sensitive research on population aging and raises awareness of the needs to address the opportunities and challenges presented by this phenomenon. In this lesson, we would like to discuss about international initiatives for elder care with focusing on the role of United Nations organization in promotion of solidarity of older persons. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to understand the initiatives of international agencies for elderly, gain knowledge on the world aging issues, acquire knowledge on the services of the international agencies for the elderly. Background of UN principles of the older persons. The General Assembly, appreciating the contribution that older persons make to their societies, reorganizing that in the Charter of recognizing that the peoples of United Nations declare inter alia their determination to reform faith and fundamental human rights in the dignity and worth of human person, in the equal rights of men and women and of nations large and small, and to promote social progress and better standards of life in larger freedom, noting the elaboration of those rights in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, and the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights and other declarations to ensure the application of universal standards to particular groups. International Plan of Aging. In pursuance of the International Plan of Action on Aging, adopted by World Assembly on Aging and endorsed by General Assembly in its resolution 37/51 of 3rd December 1982, appreciating the tremendous diversity in the situation of older persons, not only between countries, but within countries and between individuals, which requires a variety of policy responses. Aware that all in countries, individuals are reaching an advanced age in greater numbers and be better health than ever before. Aware of scientific research disproving many stereotypes about inevitable and irreversible declines with age, convinced that in a world characterized by an increasing number and proportion of older persons, opportunities must be provided for willing and capable older persons to participate in and contribute to the ongoing activities of society. Mindful that the strains on family life in both developed and developing countries require support for those providing care to frail older persons, United Nations Principles of the Older Persons, the International Plan of Action on Aging and the conventions, recommendations and resolutions of the International Labour Organization, the World Health Organization and other United Nations entities encourages governments to incorporate the following principles into their national programs wherever possible. Independence. Older persons should have access to adequate food, water, shelter, clothing and health care through the provision of income, family and community support and self-help. Older persons should have the opportunity to work or to have access to other income generating opportunities. Older persons should be able to participate in determining when and at what pace withdrawal from the labor force takes place. Older persons should have access to appropriate educational and training programs. Older persons should be able to live in environments that are safe and adaptable to personal preferences and changing capacities. Older persons should be able to reside at home for as long as possible. Participation. Older persons should remain integrated in society participate actively in the formulation and implementation of policies that directly affect their well-being and share their knowledge and skills with younger generations. Older persons should be able to seek and develop opportunities for service to the community and to serve as volunteers in positions appropriate to their interests and capabilities. Older persons should be able to form movements or associations of older persons. Care. Older persons should benefit from family and community care and protection in accordance with each society's system of cultural values. Older persons should have access to health care to help them to maintain or regain the optimum level of physical, mental, and emotional well-being and to prevent or delay the onset of illness. Older persons should have access to social and legal services to enhance their autonomy, protection, and care. Older persons should be able to utilize appropriate levels of institutional care providing protection, rehabilitation, and social and mental stimulation in a human and secure environment. Older persons should be able to enjoy human rights and fundamental freedoms when residing in any shelter, care, or treatment facility, including full respect for their dignity, beliefs, needs, and privacy, and for the right to make decisions about their care and the quality of their lives. Self-fulfillment. Older persons should be able to pursue opportunities for the full development of their potential. Older persons should have access to the educational, cultural, spiritual, and recreational resources of society. Dignity. Older persons should be able to live in dignity and security and be free of exploitation and physical or mental abuse. Older persons should be treated fairly regardless of age, gender, racial or ethnic background, disability or other status, and be valued independently of their economic contribution. International Conferences and Declarations on Aging. Universal Declaration of Human Rights. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights fundamental text describes the values, rights, and the goals of the United Nations and specifically mentions the security of human beings in their old age. Declaration of the Rights and Responsibilities of the Older Person. In 1990, the International Federation of Aging published its Declaration of the Rights and Responsibilities of Older Persons, a two-page document detailing the rights of older people regarding care, dignity, self-fulfillment, participation, and independence. This document is the foundation of the UN Principles of Older Persons adopted in December 1991, aiming to be integrated in every program for older people. International Conference on Population and Development Program of Action. At the 1994 International Conference on Population and Development in Cairo, 179 countries recognized the interdependence of population and development. The conference adopted a 20-year program of action, which includes provisions to protect older persons, particularly with regard to establishing social security systems, eliminating all forms of violence, discrimination, increasing access to healthcare, and assisting those displaced during conflict. The subsequent Madrid International Plan of Action on Aging incorporated these provisions 6 years later to the situation of older persons. The Economic, Social, and Cultural Rights of Older Persons. The Committee on Social, Economic, and Cultural Rights was created by the member states' parties to the 1995 Covenant on Economic, Social, and Cultural Rights to improve its translation into acts by drawing government's attention on the implementation's insufficiencies. This document demonstrates how the UN mainstreams older persons in its works. It contains committees' recommendations on how to implement this comprehensive treaty on older persons' economic, social, and cultural rights. MIPAA Declaration on Aging for Asia and the Pacific. A declaration of United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific adopted the Plan of Action on Aging for Asia and the Pacific convened at MIPAA from 28 September to 1st October 1998 for addressing aging issues in the region. The major areas of concern outlined in the MIPAA Declaration and Plan of Action relate to aging and older persons, including the social position of older persons and the family, health and nutrition, housing, older persons and the market, income security, maintenance and employment, and social services and the community. The plan of action also discussed structures and process for its implementation, including the re-examination of the national infrastructure for aging and older persons, intersectoral collaboration and support, coordination and monitoring, resource mobilization and allocation, regional and international cooperation. The Montreal Declaration on Rights of Older Persons. This document is the result of more than a year of deliberations and input from member groups of the International Federation on Aging throughout the world. It was officially released and turned over the United Nations Aging Unit at the closing plenary session of the IFA's Montreal International Conference in 1999. Its purpose was to guide UN policy on aging during the next decade. The International Federation on Aging. The International Federation on Aging is an international non-governmental organization founded in 1973 and based on Toronto, Ontario, Canada, working in the field of aging, older persons and aging-related issues such as ageism. The intent of the organization is for NGOs, the corporate sector, academia, government and individual working together to make a change for older people throughout the world by stimulating, collecting, analyzing and disseminating information on rights, policies and practices that improve the quality of life of people as they age. The IFA has general consultative status in the United Nations Economic and Social Council. World Health Organization, WHO Directing and Coordinating Authority on International Health within the United Nations system, WHO builds a better, healthier future for people all over the world. WHO works with 194 member states across 6 regions and from more than 150 offices. WHO staff are united in a shared commitment to achieve better health for everyone, everywhere. Not only works for issues of elderly, but also strives for combat diseases, communicable diseases like influenza and HIV, and non-communicable diseases like cancer and heart diseases. WHO helps mothers and children survive and thrive so they can look forward to healthy old age also, ensure the safety of the air people breathe, the food they eat, the water they drink, the medicines and vaccines they need. WHO focuses the programs mainly on global strategy and action plan on aging and health, which ensures adults live not only longer but healthier lives. A global strategy and action plan on aging and health was adopted in May 2016 by the World Health Assembly. This strategy focuses on 5 strategic objectives and is a significant step forward in establishing a framework to achieve healthy aging for all. It includes a call for countries to commit to action and develop age-friendly environments. It also outlines the needs to align health system to the needs of older people and the development of sustainable and equitable systems of long-term care. It emphasizes the importance of improved data, measurement and research and involving older people in all decisions that concern them. The another program, 10 Priorities for a Decade of Action on Healthy Aging, concrete actions that are needed to achieve the objectives of the WHO Global Strategy and Action Plan on Aging and Health. WHO carried out a series of consultations with experts, WHO staff and key stakeholders to identify those actions that would be transformative. Each priority is crucial for getting the world to the point where it can take on a decade of concerted action. Healthy aging will not become a reality without focusing global action. These 10 priorities provide the path forward. WHO predominantly focuses on aging and life course, commit to action, health system that meet the needs of older people, long-term care systems, data and research. UNFPA works to raise awareness about population aging and the needs to harness its opportunities and address its challenges. UNFPA also supports research and data collection to provide a solid base for policies and planning and makes sure aging issues are integrated into national development programs and poverty reduction strategies. International Council for Caring Communities. This organization was established to stimulate and showcase innovative concepts that address the impact of the age of longevity on communities worldwide. Through its research, educational programs, architectural and interior design student programs, ICCC seeks to identify successful solutions and encourages their adaptation or replication by local cultures. A conference held in February 1999 focused on caring communities for the 21st century, villages and cities for all generations. International Federation on Aging. This federation plays a significant role and provides a worldwide forum from aging issues and fosters the development of associations and agencies that serve older individuals. International Network for the Prevention of Elder Abuse. It was founded at the World Congress of Gerontology in Adelaide, Australia in 1997 to increase society's ability to recognize and respond to the mistreatment of older people. It aims for international collaboration and to have representation at all of the major conferences involving older people. Liverpool Personal Service Society. This society has provided leadership and management to establish and operate the Salmon Group, a transitional network of professional organizations providing small supported housing units for older disabled people as an alternative to large institutions. Federation International Deaf Associations Deaf Persons AGIS. This organization has undertaken many programs for the welfare of the aged. More specifically, it undertook a survey entitled Adolescents of Yesterday and Today, whose objective is to discuss issues and determine the place of young and old in the next century, participated in an international meeting organized by University of the Third Age on Senior Citizens, Society, Culture and Economy on 5th October 1998 in Santander, Spain, participated in the Global Walk on 2nd October 1999 organized by WHO with support of numerous international partners. International Association of Gerontology. This association is a premier institute which promotes research, training and practice in the field of aging as well as the interests of gerontological organizations worldwide. International Institution on Aging. This institute conducts a number of training programs in gerontology, demographics and geriatric each year, both in sight and in a INIA headquarters in Malta. In late 1997, INIA organized an intergovernmental conference on aging populations in the Mediterranean region. This was the first in a series of regional conferences that led to a global memorandum on aging, charting the needs and expectations of each region. 30 additional programs include the establishment of ad hoc working groups to focus on practical problems relating to aging. Distance learning programs for developing countries. Aging and Sustainable Development Goals. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development sets out a universal plan of action to achieve sustainable development in a balanced manner and seeks to realize the human rights of all people. It calls for leaving no one behind and for ensuring that the sustainable development goals are met for all segments of society at all ages, with a particular focus on the most vulnerable, including older persons. Preparing for an aging population is vital to the achievement of the integrated 2030 agenda, with aging cutting across the goals on poverty eradication, good health, gender equality, economic growth and decent work, reduced inequalities and sustainable cities. Therefore, while it is essential to address the exclusion and vulnerability of an intersectional discrimination against many older persons in the implementation of the new agenda, it is every more important to be beyond treating older persons as a vulnerable group. Older persons must be recognized as active agents of societal development in order to achieve truly transformative, inclusive and sustainable development outcomes. The 17 Sustainable Development Goals are part of ambitious Global Agenda 2030 adopted by world leaders in 2015 at an historic UN summit. Building upon the success of the Millennium Development Goals, which expired in 2015, the SDGs aimed to end poverty, protect the planet and ensure prosperity for all. Each goal has specific targets to be achieved by 2030. Goal 3 is to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all ages. Goal 5, to achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls, is more gender and age inclusive than previous development goals on maternal mortality. The goals contain a commitment to increase significantly the availability of high quality, timely and reliable data, which should be disaggregated by age as well as characteristics such as gender and disability. This is essential for ensuring effective policies and interventions. International Day of Older Persons. 1st October is the International Day of Older Persons is an opportunity to highlight the important contributions that older people make to society and raise awareness of the joys and challenges of aging in today's world. On 14th December 1990, the United Nations General Assembly designated 1st of October as the International Day of Older Persons. This was preceded by initiatives such as the Vienna International Plan of Action on Aging, which was adopted by the 1982 World Assembly on Aging and endorsed later that year by the UN General Assembly. World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. Elder abuse is a global social issue which affects the health and human rights of millions of older persons around the world, and an issue which deserves the attention of the international community. The United Nations General Assembly, in its resolution 66 by 127, designated June 15th as World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. It represents the one day in the year when the whole world voices its opposition to the abuse and suffering inflicted to some of our older generations. International Year of Older Persons. In 1992, the United Nations General Assembly proclaimed the year 1999 as the International Year of Older Persons. The overall objective of the year was the promotion of the United Nations principles for older persons, which address quality of life of older persons, including independence, participation, care, self-fulfillment, and dignity. After the Madrid International Plan of Action on Aging, many of international agencies are take a challenge to work for the betterment of elderly with a wide range of network. World Health Organization and United Nations organizations are playing a vital role in funding and promoting research on the issues of aging at international level. There is a need of international collaboration of agencies to work for the cause of age.